كثيرا وسبحوه Astaghfirullah, 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 اللهم محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا 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 محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم.
اللهم صل
على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
Before you eat, you clean the plate. Before you drink, you clean the cup. So I think we just clean our cups, inshallah, and we're ready to receive our divine gifts and our food, inshallah. Our hearts are vessels for accepting this. So we're going to invite Ustadh Mawlid and Nass, Uthman, and our dear Imad and his brothers up in the area of Munshidood to come and begin the mawlid of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One of the secrets of doing the mawlid these particular people, it's actually quite amazing. They've been trained, Sidi Muaz comes from a long line of Quran reciters. And his recitation and what he's been taught, is as he recites, the secrets of what he's reciting is also being put into us as our hearts are being purified and cleaned. So we're going to ask them to come and elevate us and remind us of things that we've forgotten. And we'll ask Sidi Uthman to remind us of some beautiful nasheeds that we've also forgotten over the course of our lives. And we'll ask Uthman to remind us as well.
وسلموا تسليما. Amen. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله
صلى الله عليه.
نبانا الله فقال جاءكم نور فسبحان الذي أنبانا
صلى الله عليه.
والنور طه عبده من به في ذكره عاذ به من نادى
صلى الله عليه.
ورحمة المولى تأمل قوله فليفرح ويقض به فرحانا
صلى الله عليه.
مستمسكا بالعروة الوثقى ومعتصما بحبل الله من أنشانا
صلى الله عليه.
مستشعرا أنوار من قيل متى كنت نبيا قال آدم كان
صلى الله عليه.
بين التراب وبين ماء فاستفق من غفلة أن ذا وكن يقظانا
صلى الله عليه.
وعبر إسرار رب إلى أسرار رب لم يزل ينقلني بين الخيار بصانا
صلى الله عليه.
لم تفترق من شعبتين إلا أنا في خيرها حتى بروزي أنا
صلى الله عليه.
فأنا خيار من خيار قد خرجت من نكاه لإله صانا
صلى الله عليه.
الله حماه اختاره وما براك مثله إنسانا
صلى الله عليه.
وبحبه وبذكره والنصر والثرب وابن والنصر والتوقير رب العرش قد أوصانا
يا ربنا صل وسلم دائما على حبيبك من إليك دعانا اللهم صل وسلم وبارك
وبارك لي وعلى آله
صلى الله عليه.
صلي ربي على نبي شفيعنا أحمد الله صلي ربي على نبي مولانا محمد الله صلي ربي
that you have sown, Allah, and trust.
to hear the world declare God's prophet as its own Allah. Salli Rabbi ala Nabi Shafi.
Okay. صلى الله عليه جل من معد تفاسر عن عطاه نهانا كرر ذكر وصف محمد كيما تزيع عن القلوب الرانا
يا ربنا صل وسلم دائما على حبيبك
younger, come in front of the stage.
Jain and younger.
Jain and younger. Bismillah.
Come forward.
Sit right here.
Everybody knows Jannah. Yeah.
page 22.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله
صلى الله عليه
لما دنا وقت البروز لأحمد عن إذ من ما شاءه قد كان
صلى الله عليه
حملت به الأم لمينة بنت وهب من لها أعلى إله مكانا
صلى الله عليه
من والد المختار عبد الله ابن عبد المطلب رعى البرهان
صلى الله عليه
كان يغمر نور طه وجهه وسرى إلى الإذن المصون عيانا
صلى الله عليه
وهو ابن هاشم الكريم شهد عبد مناف ابن قصي كان
صلى الله عليه
والده يدعى حكيما شأنه قد اعتلى آدف بذلك شانا
صلى الله عليه
واحفظ صمول المصطفى حتى ترى في سلسلة وصوله
علينا صلى الله عليه
هناك حفظ علم برفعه إلى إسماعيل كان للأبي
معوانا صلى الله عليه
وحينما حملت به آمنة لم تشفو شيئا يحفظ
النسوانا صلى الله عليه
وبها أحد وضط من رب السماء أوصى الأذى والهم والأحزان أن المهيمن شرف الأكوان
صلى الله عليه
بالطهر من في بطنها فاستبشرت ودنا المقاد فأطرعت رضوانا
صلى الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله الله أكبر سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله Yeah.
يا الله ربي فاغفر لي ذنوبي يا الله ببركة الهدي المشفى يا الله صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واسقنا يا رب اغثنا بحياة الطالية ما صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واختم العمرة بحسنى واحسن العقبى ومرجع صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم أحمد الطهرى وآله وصحابة مسنا شاء صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
Said, if you want to be rich, then become knowledgeable. Our dear Ustadh Ali is going to become, Charlie is going to share some of the world with us. We're not talking about cryptocurrency. Ali is going to talk to us today about how to make the sunnah of the Prophet, how to make our love for him part of our spiritual DNA.
Kids can move.
I was the replacement speaker, so I'm sorry if you wanted to see the other scholar. You'll have to make do with me, inshallah ta'ala. It's very late, so I won't take too much of your time. It's always beautiful to come to the Mawlid and see different people, different types of people, you know. And this is, I think, the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the sabab of his chosen Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he can bring all these different types of people together. Right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمِنْ آيَاتِ خَلْقُ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافُ أَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَأَلْوَانِكُمْ. From the great signs of Allah is the creation of the cosmos, the heavens and the earth, right? The creation of the universe. This is invitation to deal with the teleological argument for the existence of God, the argument that the universe is finely tuned for life, and in the variety wakhtilaf, and in the variety of your tongues or languages and colors. This is a great ayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a great burhan, an irrefutable proof of the prophecy of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that you have this type of variety just in this place. There are people here, there are Arabs here from different Arab majority countries. You have South Asian contingency. You have white Muslims, African American Muslims. You have Afghani Muslims. You have an Iranian. He's in here somewhere. I know he is.
known as the hadith, arja hadith, the most hopeful hadith, al-mar'u ma'a man ahab, right? A person will be with the one whom he loves. Why is this so hopeful? It's because the Sahaba, they knew that they loved the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I would add another hadith to this, Salmanu minna ahlil bayt. Salman al-Farisi. I have to be a little nationalistic. I'm usually the only one in the room. Ask some of my students here about what goes on in the classroom. It's probably criminal. At least some degree of racism. Hopefully not. Salmanu minna ahlil bayt. Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, kullu nasab, kullu ansab, tanqati'u yawm al-qiyama ghayra nasabi wa sababi. Every type of lineage or connection is cut off on the yawm al-qiyama, except my lineage and those who are somehow connected to me. So I can't be Ahlul Bayt, but I can be an adopted member, as it were, of Ahlul Bayt. And how do I do that? Like some man of Pharisee, you manifest an extreme mahabba for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the means by which hearts are brought together. Just look around him. Bilal al-Habashi, Suhaib al-Rumi, Salman al-Farisi. You have Abdullah ibn Salam al-Yahudi, he was ethnically Jewish. All these different types of people around him that he brought together, right? One of the names, I was actually asked also to speak about, and this is what I really sort of took notes on. Sorry if I did the wrong thing. On the names of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They're mentioned in the Quran and the Hadith. One of his names is Ni'matullah. Ni'matullah. The blessing, the blessing of God. The blessing of God. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاَعْتَسِمُوا بِحَبِلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. He says, وَاَعْتَسِمُوا, have i'tisam. I'tisam is like a grip to save your life, like you're falling off a cliff. Imagine that grip. That's why everyone should be able to do one pull-up. If you can't do one pull-up, you can't save your life. Just one. I know his brother here, Zane. I challenged him one time to a pull-up contest. He destroyed me. He said, that's okay, you'll get better. So I used to be good, and you know, I tried to save my... Anyway, it was for... One, imagine that grip on the bar. You're going to fall to your death. This is called al-i'tisam. Wa'atasimu bihabilillahi jami'an. What is habilillah? According to the hadith, it is kitabullah hablun mamdudun min as-sama'i ila al-ard. The lifeline that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extends down from the heavens to the earth. Wadhkuru ni'matallahi alaykum idh kuntum a'da'an. And remember the great blessing of God upon you. You were enemies. You were enemies. In the first instance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right, the sabab al-nuzul, the occasion of its revelation, the immediate occasion, is about the awladu qayla, the Aus and the Khazraj, the Ansar, who had fought three intertribal wars, on the brink of a fourth war. And then who came to them? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا. You were on the brink of falling into the fire. And then by means of this great ni'mah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you became brethren. وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَى حُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ فَأَنْقَذَكُمْ مِنْهَا. You were on the brink of falling into a fire, and he saved you from it. He saved you from it. SubhanAllah. One of the early Muslim converts, Khalid ibn Sa'id. This was even before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told to make public his risala. Right? So, Ibn Sa'd mentions this in the Tabaqat. This man Khalid ibn Sa'id, he had a dream. And this is obviously early Meccan period. He had a dream. And he went to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Because Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, before Islam was known as a dream interpreter, he had the ability to interpret dreams. So he went to Abu Bakr and he said, I had a dream last night. So what was your dream? I had a dream that I was standing on the edge of a lake of fire. a lake of fire. And I was on the edge, and I'm sort of teetering on the edge, and I look into the fire, and my father is there. And he's reaching out towards me. He's trying to grab a hold of me to pull me into the fire. You can imagine Abu Bakr, oh, okay, interesting. What else? He says, suddenly I felt someone come up from behind me and wrap his arms around me and pull me back and save me. It's okay. And I turn around, it's your friend. It's Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Bakr said, Ibshir, be of good cheer. He is a messenger of God. This is how he converted, Khalid ibn Sa'id. He was given a ru'ya of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saving him from the fire. SubhanAllah. So these are some of the names of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the more names that we know of him, the more we can have ma'rifah of him. Ma'rifah is intimate knowledge, right? Not surface level, very deep knowledge. The more names that we understand, we'll have more ma'rifah. And the more ma'rifah of him that we have, we'll have more mahabbah. Because ma'rifah is the path to love, unconditional love. You can't love something you don't know. You can't love someone you don't know. I can tell you to love someone. Do you love my cousin Milad? You do. So, he finds those beautiful loopholes. So, oh, well, I don't know what to do now. He took my punchline. Maybe most of you, you don't know you don't love my cousin. Why? You don't know him, right? You don't know who he is because you don't have ma'rifah of him, right? So, you know, there's some Muslims, they say, you know, they see us, we go to the Mawlid, and they say, yeah, if only you had the same love for Allah that you have for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is a misguided sentiment, right? Because the love of the Prophet is the love of Allah. They're inseparable. Why do we love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam because he is Rasulillah. He's a prophet of God. Why do we love the Quran? Kitabullah, Kalamullah, right? The speech of God. Can you imagine somebody saying, oh, you know, it would have been great if the love you had the Quran, the same type of love you had for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It doesn't make any sense. It's nonsensical. What are you talking about? We love the Quran because it's Kalamullah. We love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam because he is Rasulullah, right? When I was in Yemen, there was an American professor who came to the Mawlid in Tarim. And he admitted to me later he was a missionary. But it was sort of on the DL, you know. I'm a missionary, by the way. He says, you should come to the Mawlid, okay? So I was watching his face the whole Mawlid. And he was just like... Then I asked him after, I said, what did you think? And I'll never forget, he said, This is almost, inshallah, a direct quote. He said, the love of the Prophet staggers me. Staggers me. I said, yeah, subhanAllah, it does. And then he said, because he kind of meant that in a sort of, and he said, I wonder how some of your co-religionists would feel about this. So what do you mean? You know, this kind of love, it's kind of excessive, don't you think? It's kind of excessive. There's no way we can be excessive with the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because wallahu ya'simuka minan nas. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects him from anyone worshiping him. There's never been any group that has outwardly worshiped the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has protected him from people taking him as an ilah. This is incredible, right? We don't have this type of isma with sahaba, for example. There's an interesting statement related to Sayyidina Ali, karamallahu wajha, which is in Sunni and Shi'i sources. Nahjul Balagha mentions it. It's also in Suyuti's Tarikhul Khulafa or Rashideen that Sayyidina Ali, he says, Sayyahliku fi sinfan. Two groups on account of me are destroyed. Muhibbun mufritun yadhabu bihi al-hub ila ghayri al-haq. The one who loves me so much, it takes him from the truth. وَمُبْغِدٌ مُفْرِتٌ يَذْهَبُ بِهِ الْبُغْضِ إِلَى غَيْرِ الْحَقِّ And the one who hates me so much, it takes him from the truth. And he said, Khayrun Nas, the best people are those who are in the middle with respect to me. Right? And then he said, فَأَلْزَمُ الْأَسْوَادَ الْأَعْظَمُ. So stick to the great majority. فَإِنَّ يَدُ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْجَمَاعَةِ. This is a hadith. For the protective power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with the majority. Right? So we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can imagine somebody said, if only you love your country as much as you love your flag, whatever country it might be. The flag represents the country. It's a symbol of the country. Imagine somebody whose mother passed away and they're looking at the picture of their mother. If only you love your mother more, as much as you love your picture of the mother. What? What are you talking about? It's a nonsensical argument. We love Allah, we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, liwajhillah, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one of his names that is mentioned by the ulama is Abdullah, mentioned in Surah Jinn, ayah number 19. The perfect slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The perfect slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is his primary title in the Quran. Subhana alladhi asra bi abdihi, alhamdulillahi alladhi anzala 'ala abdihi al-kitaba wa lam yaj'alhu 'iwaja. Tabaraka alladhi nazzala al-furqana 'ala abdihi. You know, a lot of modern people find this disturbing. We say, we are ibadullah. A lot of modern people say, what, you're a slave of God? I'm not a slave to nobody. I make my own rules. Right? This type of individualism is egocentrism. The opposite of egocentrism is theocentrism. Right? That we are theocentric, and a lot of people find this very strange. It's very weird. That's fine. I'm okay with weird. فَتُوبَ لِلْغُرَبَى. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, towards the end of time, you're going to be weird. We were weird at the beginning when we were, you know, talking about wahdaniya and ahadiya amongst these mushrikeen. We're talking about halal and haram. This was very weird for the Arabs. فَسَيَعُودُ كَمَا بَدَأَ. It's going to again become weird. فَتُوبَ لِلْغُرَبَى. Glad tidings to the weirdos. It's so weird. You don't drink alcohol? Like clockwork, every week on Friday, when I was in the corporate world, when I was sitting in the cubicle, sometimes I still sit in the cubicle. It's okay, don't worry about it. You gotta do what you gotta do. You coming to happy hour? No, I don't drink. 7 days later. You coming to happy hour? No, don't drink. 7 days later. Happy hour? No. Happy hour? No. That's so weird. It's weird being a slave of God, right? But these same people, their nafs says, Ya Abdi, they say, Labbaik. Ya Abdi, Labbaik, Labbaik, at your service. Everyone worships someone, right? Araita man ittakhadha ilahahu hawa. Right? Have you seen the one who takes his hawa, like his desire, you know? Like when you go to Hawaii, you let it all hang out. You know, you go to Hawaii and you look on the ground and you see, oh, Honolulu, Honolulu, there's a pearl. Honolulu, sorry. That was a bad joke. Sorry about that. You know, but you think in terms of human slavery, yeah, it's very disturbing. In a relationship, in the Sayyid sort of abd relationship, you know, if you have a human slave, who benefits from that relationship? The slave master benefits, right? But in the Rab Marbub relationship, who benefits? Do we benefit Allah? Who benefits? The abd, completely. We cannot benefit Allah one iota, right? And this is why when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would hear his title Abdullah in the Quran, his eyes would fill up with tears, because this is the greatest thing. This is the greatest title that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can bestow upon a human being. That you are Abdullah. You are the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَوْحَى إِلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ مَا أَوْحَى. Beyond the Sidratul Muntaha, where Jibril alayhi salam cannot go, or else he'd combust into flames. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I told my Ab a few things. فَأَوْحَى إِلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ مَا أَوْحَى مَا. What's مَا? Don't worry about it. Secrets between lovers. Ibn Mas'ud, he says, the prayer is made fard, the wa'd of Jannah, the promise of paradise, right? That's all we know. What else? Secrets between lovers. فَأَوْحَى إِلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ مَا أَوْحَى. So the Prophet ﷺ was sitting on his knees and he was eating a date, and a Jewish woman passed by and she said, your prophet eats like a slave. He said, أَلَسْتُ بِعَبْدِ. Am I not a slave? Am I not a slave? Look how he responds to people, right? He's not, to use the term in academia nowadays, he's not so easily triggered, right, by these microaggressions. I'm triggered, I need a safe space. I need to go somewhere and play with Play-Doh, play with Legos, you know, play some Pac-Man. You guys know what Pac-Man is? Yeah. I had the Atari 2600 way back in the day. That was my first game, Pac-Man. Now you play Halo. A little different. But look at his response. Am I not a snake? That's it. Situation diffused. Right? Our mother Aisha said, why do you pray all night? What for? أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Should I not be a grateful servant? Right? He perfected Ubudiyya. And Shakur is interesting. This is another one of his names, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Shakur, the Shakir, is the one who is thankful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in times of prosperity. He's Shakir, active participle. The Shakur is also an active participle, but it's a more emphatic form, meaning the one who thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in adversity and in times of deprivation. He says, Alhamdulillah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every state. And why is that? It's because he has unconditional love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is another one of his names. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Habibullah, the beloved of God. There's numerous hadith. There's one in Tirmidhi. Ala wa ana Habibullah wa la fakhr. I am the beloved of God and I do not boast. Oftentimes the ulama, they use the analogy of marriage. They call it a living parable for love of God or mystical union with God. The ulama say there's four levels of love. There's four words in Arabic for love. If you're familiar with C.S. Lewis, he has a book called The Four Loves. It's the same in New Testament tradition, Greek tradition. The first love is called mawadda. Mawadda, right? And this means something like affection or a willingness to sort of sacrifice for another person, right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, he says that he put وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ between the spouses, a man and his wife, mawadda wa rahma. Mawadda wa rahma. This type of affection and mercy. Because this is something else that's weird about us. When we get married, we're not necessarily in love. Sometimes it happens, the Bollywood movie comes true. Most of the time, it doesn't really happen. You don't even really know the person you're marrying. So why are you doing this? That's so weird. You guys are weird, man. You guys are weirdos. Why are we doing this? Because we're trying to follow the Sharia. We're trying to follow the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We don't want to offend Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We want to uphold the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there's mawadda. What is mawadda? So there's a willingness to compromise, to work with each other. There's affection. Right? Just let me know when I'm going over time. I don't want to go too long. I think people are getting restless. So this is the first sort of level. It's love, but it's more like an affectionate type of love. The name Dawood is taken from Mawadda. Wood. Dawood. Mawadda. But then you go to Khulla, to stick with the marriage analogy. So you're married, and I'll speak from the perspective of a man, because I'm a man, and I believe that there's two genders. You need a safe space for that.
I don't care.
So when you marry your wife, there's mawadda, and then lo and behold, you start to like her, right? You want to do things with her. That's called khulla. That's called friendship love. Right? You want to watch a movie together, halal movie, probably not Bollywood. Anyway, you want to go bowling together, right? You want to spend time together. This is friendship love, khulla. Right, so we come out of mawadda. Right? It's not like, okay, nice to see you, nice dinner, I'm gonna go bowling with the guys. I mean, you can do that, I guess. But, be careful. And then you go to ishq. Ishq is like intimate love, right? Which is, it's temporary, it's fleeting. And then you get to mahabba. Mahabba is unconditional love. So this person, this is a level of love for your spouse, they fall short. Sometimes they say things to you, right? They make mistakes, but that's okay. You love them unconditionally. You overlook these things. The love is always going to be there. So these four levels of love are also used when describing our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That there's mawadda, right? There's a willingness to compromise. And how do we accomplish this? It's through the ibadat, right? We start to pray. We pray fajr. I have a saying, never trust a person who doesn't pray fajr. Maybe it's not a good saying. But, I mean, there's a hadith, the difference between a mu'min and a kafir is as-salah. And most of the ulama say this is not an essential difference, but an attributive difference. In other words, if a Muslim is not praying, they're sort of acting like an unbeliever. But Ahmad ibn Hanbal said, it's an essential difference. If you don't pray, you're not Muslim. Right? So, mawadda of Allah intimates this idea that you're willing to go through some sacrifice. Even if you don't really know why you're doing it, you know you have to do it. You wake up, you pray fajr, right? You read some Quran, even if you don't understand. And then you get to khulla. How do we establish a friendship type love with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How do you establish a friendship type relationship with Allah? Is with dua, right? Dua. Speak to Allah in a language that you understand. So I don't understand Arabic. Try to make an attempt to understand what you're saying in the prayer. But then in your dua, a dua mukhul ibadah. There's a hadith that dua is the essence of worship. And this is how you become friends. This is how you become the khalil of Allah. You speak to Allah. You pour your heart out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then ishq. How do we actualize ishq, intimate love with Allah? We make dhikr of Allah, we reflect upon the ni'am of Allah. And then finally, mahabba is through gnosis and total taslim of his qadr. Total submission to the decree of Allah. He probably did what all of you want to do, or most of you may do. Don't get out of my room. So, mahabba, unconditional love, is attained by total taslim to his qadr. Like one of the awliya said, when I'm in the shade, I don't want to be in the sun. Allah put me in the shade. When I'm in the sun, I don't want to be in the shade. Allah put me in the sun. I am totally in a state of reservation with Allah, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does with me. As long as he's not angry with me. Right? This was the only concern of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the day of Ta'if. being stoned out of the city, being chased out of the city for 3 miles. People say, oh, he left the city, he's okay. No, they followed him outside of the city gates for 3 miles. They're aiming for his legs, according to the traditions, because they want to break his legs so he'll fall down and kill him. This is what they want to do. This was an attempted murder. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he makes the beautiful dua, is, you know, he said, if this is all happening to me and you're not angry, fala ubali, I don't mind. I don't mind. This is what you want to do with me? No problem. But if you're angry with me, then that's, I'm concerned about that. If this is happening because you have ghadab of me, then there's a concern. I have to make a change here. But if not, you're pleased with me and this is happening because it is your qadr, fala ubali, then I don't mind. This is someone who is Habibullah, the beloved of God. When should I stop talking? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us understand what was said tonight and to be able to incorporate and inculcate these beautiful things that we say about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and have it manifest in our character. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to have mahabba, to have unconditional love for him and his messenger.
Please sit down. There's a lot of fire.
So I'm going to say the dua for the book first. Page 46 if you want to follow, inshallah. Otherwise, just say Ameen, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajeem. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi. Wa laqad ashartu lil'ati man awsafu wa tuhyi al-quluba tuhayyiju al-ashjala. والله قد أثنى عليه فما يساوي القول منا أو يكون ثلالا لكن حبا في السرائر قد دعا لمذيح صفوة ربنا وحنانا وإذا امتزجنا بالمودة هاهنا نرفع أيدي فقرنا ورجانا للواحد الأحد العلي إلهنا متوسلين بمن إليه دعانا مختاره وحبيبه وصفيه زين الوجود به الإله حبانا يا ربنا يا ربنا يا ربنا بالمصطفى اقبلنا أجب دعوانا أنت لنا يا ذخرنا في هذه الدنيا وفي أخرانا واصلح لنا الأحوال واغفر ذنبنا ولا تؤاخذ ربي إن أخطانا واسلك بنا في نهج طاع المصطفى ثبت على قدم الحبيب خطانا أرنا بفضل منك طلعة أحمد في بهجة عين الرضا ترعانا واربط بي في كل حال حبلنا وحبال من ود ومن والانا والمحسنين ومن أجاب نداءنا بالحقوق وطالبا أوصانا والحاضرين وساعيا في جمعنا ها نحن بين يديك أنت ترانا ولقد رجوناك فحقق سؤلنا واسمع بفضلك يا سميع دعانا وانصر بنا سنة طافي بقاع الأرض واقمع كل من عادانا وانظر إلينا واسقنا كأس الهنا واشف وعاف عاجلا مرضانا وانظر إلينا واسقنا كأس الهنا واشف وعاف عاجلا مرضانا الحاجات واحسن ختمنا عند الممات وأصلح العقبانا يا رب واجمعنا وأحبابا لنا في ذلك الفردوس يا رجوانا يا رب واجمعنا وأحبابا لنا في ذلك الفردوس يا رجوانا يا رب واجمعنا للمصطفى صل عليه وآله ما حركت ريح الصبا أغصانا سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين
اللهم لك الحمد حمدا كثيرا مبارك فيه اللهم لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك ولعظيم سلطانك اللهم لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله وإليك يرجع الأمر كله اللهم لك الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى ولك الحمد إذا رضيت ولك الحمد بعد الرضا اللهم لك الحمد بما هديتنا وخلقتنا ورزقتنا وفرجت عنا اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وذريته وأهل بيته وسلم تسليم كثير إلى يوم الدين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين وصل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين اللهم اجمع جمعنا هذا جمعا مباركا مرحوما اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مباركا مرحوما وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا سالما موفقا من الشر معصوما اللهم لا تجعل فينا ولا منا ولا معنا شقيا ولا محروما ولا معذبا بنار اللهم ارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم لا تعذبنا فأنت علينا قادر اللهم الطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير إنك على كل شيء قدير اللهم إنا نسألك حبك وحب نبينا وحبيبنا المصطفى سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ونسألك حب الأولياء والصالحين ونسألك حب الفقراء والمساكين ونسألك حب عبادك أجمعين اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم ارض عنا برضاك يا رب العالمين اللهم ارض عنا برضاك الأكبر يا رب العالمين اللهم إنا نسألك في هذه الليلة المباركة أن ترزقنا شفاعة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وأن تدخلنا الجنة اللهم ادخلنا الجنات الفردوس الأعلى يا رب العالمين مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا من كان سببا في جمعنا فاللهم اجمع له كل خير اللهم اجمع له كل خير وابعد عنه كل ضر يا رب العالمين اللهم بارك لنا في هذا المسجد وبارك لنا في هذا المكان ووفقنا لما تحبه وترضاه اللهم زدنا من فضلك ولا تنقصنا اللهم زدنا من فضلك ولا تنقصنا وآثرنا ولا تؤثر علينا يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين We all make dua for the volunteers. We say جزاكم الله خيرا بارك فيكم
اللهم يا ارحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين نور قلوبنا وقلوبهم بالعلم ونور قلوبنا وقلوبهم بالذكر ونور قلوبنا وقلوبهم بمحبة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بارك الله فيكم وزادكم الله من فضله وإحسانه آمين 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 also special dua for sick people اللهم اشف كل مريض يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم ببركه القران الكريم وببركه الذكر اللهم اشف مرضانا يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم عافهم يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم عافهم مما هم فيه يا رب العالمين please please special dua for brother Usama اللهم اشفه يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم اشفه يا رب العالمين اللهم اشفه انك على كل شيء قدير اللهم اشفه انت الشافي لا شفاء الا شفاءك شفاء لا يغادر سقما ولا يترك ألما انك على كل شيء قدير special dua for all our scholars and شيوخ بارك الله فيهم الشيخ حمزة إمام زيد اللهم زيدهم من فضلك يا الله اللهم بارك فيهم يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم زيدهم نورا على نور يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين Please, special dua for brothers whose sisters, brothers and sisters have passed away recently and some of them, if they were here, they will be with us صلى الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يرحمهم رحمة واسعة اللهم ارحمهم رحمة واسعة اللهم ارحمهم واغفر لهم يا رب العالمين اللهم اغفر لنا ولهم يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم نورهم يا رب العالمين وادخلنا وإياهم الجنة برحمتك ونجينا من النار بعفوك يا أرحم الراحمين Please special dua for our sisters, our kids إن شاء الله اللهم احفظ أولادنا اللهم احفظ أولادنا اللهم احفظ أولادنا اللهم احفظ بناتنا اللهم بارك فيهم يا رب العالمين اللهم بارك فيهم يا رب العالمين اللهم حببنا وإياهم الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان واجعلنا من الراشدين اللهم احفظنا من الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن اللهم احفظنا وأولادنا من الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين اللهم زدنا من فضلك ولا تنقصنا وكثرنا ولا تنقصنا واهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا هداة المهتدين لا ضالين ولا مضلين ولا فاتنين ولا مفتونين يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين كما جمعتنا في هذه الليلة المباركة اللهم فاجمعنا مع حبيبنا في الجنة اللهم اجمعنا مع حبيبنا في الجنة اللهم اجمعنا مع حبيبنا في الجنة يا رب العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد الفاتحة على نية القبول إن شاء الله بسم الله